Hello, my name is Ermolos Psarianos. I'm a PhD student from University of Macedonia in Thessaloniki, in Greece. And the title of my paper for the International Conference about the Future of Education is The Conceptual Meaning of Experience in Jewish Educational Philosophy. John Dewey was one of the most influential American philosophers and educators. His name was associated with the movement of realism, a philosophical movement that was born in America in the second half of the 19th century. Some of the versions are also known under the names of instrumentalism and experimentalism. The main feature of the philosophy of pragmatism is the empirical concept. It accepts that the human experience is the ultimate source and the trial of all knowledge and values. The main pragmatic maxim, as formulated by Dewey, argues that the values of its concept, its knowledge, as well as the meaning of its proposal, lies on practical consequences. The choice of operation versus the theory can be seen in the way pragmatists define knowledge. For example, Dewey said that if we could understand that knowledge is not an act of an outer viewer, but of someone who participates in the natural and the social scheme, then the true object of knowledge lies on the consequences of the guided action. Dewey noted the relationship between education and experience and declared his belief that every genuine form of education is born of experience. Center of Dewey's philosophical interest is the theory of knowledge. He rejects the term theory of knowledge and prefers the term theory of inquiry or experimental logic as conditions more representative of his approach. The purpose of knowledge is to induce changes in different empirical situations, to investigate whether the knowledge gained is true or false, to propose and establish the pragmatic theory of truth. The truth of acquiring knowledge is a function of the practice of operating its consequences. That means if this knowledge has a practical benefit, it is useful and true. If, however, knowledge has no benefits at a practical level, then there is a need for further research. Dewey, influenced by Hegelian philosophy, supports the dual aspect, namely the subjective and intersubjective dimensions of the reconstruction of knowledge, highlighting the inherent and continuous interaction between man and his experience with the social environment. According to him, the human experience is considered as a special type of interaction with the environment, in which the one side defines and shapes the other, and simultaneously it is shaped by it, opening up possibilities for new forms of coping with the situations and forming of activities. The knowledge is never final and subject to constant criticism can lead to revision. This process as a whole is what is called critical thinking, which relates the value system. Knowledge does not come directly from experience but from the mental processing. With the simultaneous introduction of the concept of conciliation and experience, he supported the construction of a new reality with the action of any person. According to Dewey's philosophy, knowledge does not refer to an external, independent and subjective reality, but it actively participates and it is shaped in practice with particular connotation in learning as a dialectical process that integrates the experience and the concepts of observation and judgment through knowledge, and not simply as a process with a beginning, middle, and end. It is worth mentioning the central role of experience in the process of learning and cognitive development. Dewey, by placing the experience base of the pedagogic process, defines it as knowledge-based practice, meaning that we experience a situation first, then act in this either intellectually or practically. The culmination of this intellectual activity or practice is knowledge. Experience is the result of continuous interaction between humans and the environment. This is the main feature of the experience. At this point, it is obvious the influence of the philosophy of Darwin in his theory of evolution. He configures a specific conception of experience which includes action, pleasure, and learning by experience. In this broad view, he has for the experience incorporates the cognitive experience is something that derives from it and predisposes. Dewey makes a distinction between a primary and a secondary experience. The primary experience is composed of material interaction with the physical and social environment. The secondary experience is a reflective experience that makes the environment and it thinks as objects of reflection and knowledge. It is a failure and uncertainty of the primary experience that gives rise to reflective thought and learning. From the late 19th century, in both Europe and America developed a strong criticism of an old school and put the goals for new education. The educational ideas of Dewey had such a significant impact on educational thinking globally, so the view that was expressed was that no educator since Comenius was more recognized internationally than Dewey and any no one else's projects were so much translated around the world. Dewey contrasts the traditional form of education with a more modern approach of the educational process, which included a perceptive pattern of experience. The contrast between the two forms of education is strongly emphasized, and he concludes that there is a close and necessary link between education and experiences. The methodological principle of learning by doing is the essence of the educational thought of Dewey, highlighting the experience as the dominant method of approximation of reality and knowledge of things. According to Dewey, the experience transfers the principles, connection and organization of information or stuff from which it is made of within itself. The crucial point, therefore, in order for the behavior to be explained or predicted, is the meditation of personal experience. In order someone to create behavior with incentives, they could create the experience of awakening, commitment and pursuit. For Dewey, the reflection is the starting point for the action and he aims to help the person get out of their deadlock, resolving problematic situations. John Dewey tries to bring the educational process to a new basis. He is radically opposed to the traditional philosophy of education, based on prefabricated materials courses. This, in his opinion, persistence of ready knowledge of the past does not seem to offer something extra. It is not enough to solve the problems faced by the educational system. The method of problem solving, the project method and the active method actually help in this direction. All that is necessary to operate in a specific context which is defined by Lederman as follows. We cannot start from the knowledge of various objects with the idea that the future can be helpful in this knowledge. The facts and information used from different knowledge areas, but not with the logic of accumulation, but with this problem solving. He introduces a new empirical philosophy at school, where every experience creates a genuine form of education. The issue, however, that troubles him is to separate the experiences with positive and creative value with those that are negative, as he emphasizes that not all experiences have positive educational value. Thus, experience and education are not strictly related. The school must provide students with experiences that are carefully selected and in that way guided so as to prepare in the most appropriate way the students for their future life and provide a solid basis for future relevant experiences they will gain within society. Approaching the concept of experience that you identifies that an experience is always what it is because for its duration a transaction occurs between the individual and what that moment is the person's environment. By adjusting the above position in the education, he argues that to learn from experience is a realization of a bidirectional connection between what you act on things and what we consistently enjoy or suffer from things. In this way, he gives the experience a twofold existence. It is simultaneously has both an active and a passive element, and in some special way, almost inaccessible to mind, the experience manages to combine harmoniously both components. From the active side, the experience is experiencing, and from the passive side, is affected. When something becomes an object of our experience, we act on it, do something with it, and then undergo or suffer the consequences. This is a curious combination. The linking of these two phases of experience is the measure of effectiveness or its value, since the simple activity is not an experience. Dewey eloquently describes the nature of experience and the responsibility of the school to select and organize them, since it aims at a substantial education. No experience is born and dies alone. Completely independent of desire and will, every experience lives in the next experience. Thus, the central problem of education based upon the experience is to choose the kind of those experiences which survive productively in the next experiences. Interesting is his theory of the role of school. The school is not about the student's assimilation. The opposite. It should be emerging as a means for the renewal of society. In this way, we realize the special importance that experience acquires in the educational activity, shifting the center of the learning process to the student's experiences. So, every learning activity should be based on the experiences and the interests of the student who gets learning on its head. Thank you for your attention.